Siegel Foundation for the Arts, Kolkata. We welcome you all for this inaugural ceremony today. I now request the dignitaries to commence this evening's program by please coming on the stage and lighting the lamp. Thank you. Thank you so much. You may please take your seats on the dais. Director of National Gallery of Modern Art, Bangalore, to deliver the welcome address, please. Please, ma'am.
Everybody. Art is one medium with which one can explore and also be able to really transmit all the emotional feelings as well as all the happenings that are there around them. And for today's exhibition, the Tea Garden Journal and Other Drawings by Somnath Hoar, we have with us Mr. Chandrasekhar, Deputy Director General of Doordarshan, Bangalore. And what better person than the DDG of Doordarshan to come for this exhibition's inauguration? Art is not only for one person, it is to be also given sufficient publicity. And I think by him gracing this occasion, it's the ideal thing for art to really come alive once again. I welcome you, sir, for this inaugural session and for kindly accepting our invitation to inaugurate this exhibition. Mr. Vasudev, an eminent artist, does not require any introduction as far as NGMA is concerned. Very often he tells us that NGMA is his baby, and I still consider that even though he is no longer the member of the advisory committee, he continues to pour the same amount of affection on NGMA, and without even thinking one second, he readily accepted to be the guest of honor today and to be a part of this program. I welcome you, sir, for this inaugural ceremony. And What is in store for us today as far as this exhibition is concerned? The Siegel Foundation for Arts, under the very careful coordination of Mr. Naveen Kishore and the hard and sincere work of Mrs. Meghna Malhotra, has put forward this Tea Garden Journal and Other Drawings of Somnath Hoar in such a manner, some of the best and the least seen drawings of his, for the art lovers of Bengaluru. I thank the Siegel Foundation for having chosen NGMA Bangalore for exhibiting the works of Mr. Somnath Hoar. And I am sure it's going to be a very delightful exhibition, as he has used the pencil and ink media on paper to showcase the social world of the tea garden workers. I'm sure we will be able to empathize with the drawings and draw inspiration into other works of art. I welcome you all once again. Thank you
for your warm words. Now, as a small token of appreciation, I request Dr. Satyabhama ma'am to please present a bouquet to Sri N. Chandrasekhar, Deputy Director General, Doordarshan. I request ma'am to present a bouquet to Sri S. G. Vasudev. I request ma'am to present a bouquet to Mrs. Meena Megha Malhotra. Guest of honor, Sri S. G. Vasudev, to please come here and share a few words with us.
ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಡಿರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಎ ಸೆಡ್, ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮೈ ಬೇಬಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಹವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಎಮ್ ಎ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟುಡೇ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್. As you all know, Bangalore is very proud to have an NGMA like this, and I am told by quite a few artists of eminence and others that this is the best NGMA in the country. We are very proud of that. I am delighted to be here at this very important exhibition of one of India's very important artists, Somnath Hoare. I thank Siegel Foundation for the Arts of Kolkata for bringing such an exhibition to Bangalore, and I thank National Gallery of Modern Art for organizing the same. Somnath Hoare, undoubtedly one of the most significant artists of the country and in this century. He spent most of his time teaching at Shantiniketan, founded by Rabindranath Tagore. Somnath Hoare was a very sensitive artist who believed in expressing his art of socially marginalized people, as he was influenced by his affiliation with the Communist Party, which I really like very much. Somnath Hoare's drawings from the Tea Garden Journal, which are part of this exhibition, are very evocative, representing the struggles of workers, migrants, laborers who fought against the British hegemony for their rights. Karnataka had a lot of connections with Somnath Hoare. A number of art students from our state went to Shantiniketan to study under him. Some of them are Chandranath Acharya, Chandrasekhar, Ramdas Tadyantaya, Shyam Sundar, Doddamani, Prakash Babu, and others. They have all benefited from his teaching and have become important artists in today's contemporary art scene. Maybe the organizers could think of arranging some outreach programs around this exhibition by inviting some of Somnath Hoare's students whom I have mentioned. Like, you know, there could be a discussion on how he was teaching, because many people do not know how those masters were teaching, you know. It's very important for people to know. And then I'm sure these artists are able to sort of explain all those things to people in Bangalore. I'm sure the Bangaloreans would enjoy this unique exhibition, and I thank the organizers for inviting me here. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your words, and thank you for your suggestions. We'll try to see what we can do about that. I now request Mrs. Meena Megha Malhotra from the Siegel Foundation for the Arts, Kolkata, to please share a few words with us.
Respected chief guest, respected guest of honor, director, NGMA, thank you very much, and guests, of course. Thank you all very much for being here this evening at the inauguration of this exhibition, Tea Garden Journals and Other Drawings by Somnath Hoare. A workers' union movement was born in the mid-1930s in the tea gardens of Bengal, protesting the oppression of owners and managers. The struggle ranged from union men organized by the Communist Party on one side against the owners, their thugs, the tea garden managers, and the constabulary on the other. It is a tribute to the organizers and activists that they managed, despite such powerful opposing forces, to wrench concessions out of the companies at that time. It was to document this struggle that the Communist Party sent Somnath Hoare, complete with sketchpad and journal. This journal was published in the form of a book, The Tea Garden Journal, by Seagull Books in 2009. The exhibition, Tea Garden Journals and Other Drawings by Somnath Hoare, consists of 66 original drawings from the journal and 108 pen and ink drawings from various sketchbooks. Somnath Hoare was born in Baroma, Chittagong district, in 1921. He taught at the Indian Art College and the Delhi Polytechnic before teaching at Kalabhavan, Santiniketan. He was also a visiting lecturer at Baroda for a short while. The following extract from My Concepts of Art, an autobiographical essay by the artist, published by Seagull Books, gives us a powerful insight into Somnath Hoare's notions regarding art and politics, and the interrelationships between them, which are the hallmark of all of this great artist's work across various media. From June 1945, I worked at the Calcutta Corporation for almost a year. There, I used to teach the slum children, from PE to art, with Bengali, geography, maths, history, etc., thrown in for good measure. Once every week, I'd hand them colors and brush and ask them to draw whatever they pleased. The results of their exertions never failed to amaze me. The innocence of childhood was helping them represent their day-to-day existence, where beauty entered through both color and feeling. It remains a fact that we tend not to experience the agony of the rickshaw puller's existence by pulling a rickshaw ourselves. Instead, we experience his pain vicariously through a combination of empathy and feeling. We never consider that, were he to obtain brush and color, he too might want to terminate his daily labors and remain in the midst of bird and flower, tree and plant, branch and vine. He's even entertained by the pictures of his favorite film stars, but by works representing the grimness of life? Never, and under no circumstance. Of course, it is entirely possible that were he to take up easel because of an inner drive, he might flood the canvas with blood, sweat, and tears. Somnath Hoare worked in various media over the years, printmaking, drawing, watercolor, and sculpture in later years. His published works include Tebagar Diary and Amar Chitra Babuna. Both of these have been published by Seagull Books. He lived and worked in Shantiniketan until his death on October 1, 2006. During the last 6 years of his life, he could not work due to his illness and blindness. Even so, he did several small drawings and watercolors. Arguably the most important political artist of the country, R. Sivakumar, noted art historian, says about Somnath Hoare, "We do not choose suffering, and often we do not choose heroism, but suffering often compels us to be heroic. Somnath Hoare was an artist who led a quiet and heroic life. Quiet because he always kept himself away from the glare of the art world. And heroic because he chose to stand by the suffering and held steadfast to his political and thematic commitments, even though he knew this meant treading a lonely path. He kept himself away from the din of art, not because art was a lesser passion for him, but because life mattered more an art that did not stand witness to human suffering did not mean much to him. And human suffering was for him, as a communist, not an existential predicament into which we are all born, but something always socially engendered. He was awarded the Padma Bhushan posthumously. Among the many awards that he received in his lifetime are the Abon Gogon Award, the Lalit Kala Ratna, and the Ravindra Bharati University Award. This exhibition is representative of this artist's great social and political commentary in the form of powerful, thought-provoking art. On behalf of the Siegel Foundation for the Arts, I am indeed very grateful to Director NGMA for the opportunity to display this exhibition here. A very special thank you to all the staff of NGMA for the tireless work they have put in to make this show a reality. Thank you.
Thank you so much for giving us a glimpse of the artist, his artistic career, his own thoughts, sharing with us. Thank you. Now I request Sri N. Chandrasekhar, Deputy Director General Doordarshan, to please come here and share a few words with us. Thank you.
Dear friends, good evening to all. Ma'am, thank you for inviting me as chief guest for today's function. And I am truly pleased to be here this evening for the inauguration of the show Tea Garden Journal and other drawings of Somnath Hoare. I am informed that this exhibition consists of 66 original drawings from the journal and 108 pen and ink drawings from various sketchbooks, and has been brought by the Siegel Foundation of Arts, Kolkata. I appreciate the hard work and sincere efforts of the organization in bringing such a unique show to all of us. Somnath Hoare has been presented with many awards such as Padma Vibhushan, Lalit Kala Ratna, and Rabindra Bharati University Award. I feel very happy to be here this evening and eagerly look forward to see the works of Somnath Hoare. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, we have the catalogues of the show with us, and I would like to request Sri S.G. Vasudev to kindly release the catalogues for us. Thank you so much. Now, I would like to call upon my colleague, Mr. Darshan, Assistant Curator, to formally give the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Vasvi. On behalf of NGMA, I now present the vote of thanks. First and foremost, a sincere thanks to Sri N. Chandrasekhar for accepting our invitation and taking time out from his busy schedule to be part of this inaugural ceremony. Thank you, sir. I thank Sri S.G. Vasudev for his esteemed presence for the evening. Thank you, sir. I also extend our gratitude to Srimati Meena Megha Malhotra, Dr. Satyabhama Badrinath, and members of Advisory Committee, NGMA Bengaluru. Thank you, ma'am. We would also like to acknowledge Siegel Foundation for the Arts, Kolkata, for making this exhibition possible. And finally, my colleagues and staff members at NGMA Bengaluru for their support. Thank you all. We will now have a formal inauguration ceremony by Sri N. Chandrasekhar and viewing of the exhibition, followed by the high tea at the cafeteria. I request you all to be present at the cafeteria after viewing of the exhibition for the high tea. Before we close, an announcement to make. On 27th February at 5 p.m., Dr. Ashrafi Bhagat, Chennai-based art historian, will be delivering a talk titled Reinventing Tradition, a Perspective on Madras Art Movement at the NGMA Auditorium. Please do join us for this talk and follow us on Twitter for further exhibitions and events. Thank you all.